They say that no man's an island. John Carpenter and Kurt Russell seem to disagree. So, seeing that Corey can't be here with us tonight because he's out on a supply run, I thought we could do something different. You and me just broing down, but instead of us making the decision whether or not this film should be saved, and we damn well know that it should be because it is a masterpiece, I thought we could take a look at something in my personal collection. Something that made Escape from New York very cool, and that was Kurt Russell's wardrobe. Anyway, enough of me yakking on. Why don't we go take a look at this piece and we'll take it from there.
Where are you going, buddy?
To the war, Plissken. We need him alive.
Give a fuck about your war. Or your president.
Is that your answer?
Thinking about it.
Think hard.
Plissken, what are you doing?
Playing with myself. I'm going in.
S.D. Plissken, American, Lieutenant, Special Forces Unit, Black Light. Two Purple Hearts, Leningrad and Siberia. Youngest man to be decorated by the President. He robbed the Federal Reserve Depository, life sentence, New York Maximum Security Penitentiary. I'm ready to kick your ass out of the world. Something we've been fooling around with. Two microscopic capsules lodged in your arteries. They're already starting to dissolve. In 22 hours, the cores will completely dissolve. Inside the cores are a heat-sensing charge. Not a large explosive, about the size of a pinhead. Just big enough to open up both your arteries. I'd say you'd be dead in 10 or 15 seconds.
Protected by the cores. 15 minutes before the last hour is up, we can neutralize the charge with X-rays.
We'll burn out the charges if you have the present.
What if I'm a little late?
No more Hartford Summer, and no more Snake Plissken.
When I get back, I'm gonna kill you.
The Gulf Fire's waiting.
I hope you liked it. I know that there's a hell of a lot of John Carpenter and Escape from New York fans out there. Something that I wanted to do for a while, and Corey and I were discussing about showcasing some of the little things that we've collected over time in between our shows. So look for that.
Oh, and getting back to Snake Plissken,
there's a part of me, a strong part of me, that's really hoping Kurt Russell has survived the apocalypse and he's out there wandering the wasteland in his Snake Plissken fatigue, which I believe he kept after the filming of Escape from New York. So that, that puts a smile on my face. It's kind of interesting to look at the original publicity stills and the progression of the character to the actual finished product when the film was released. Wardrobe-wise, I think some of the test shots and the original conceptual paintings, I think it was originally slated for Charles Bronson. I mentioned that before. Because in Fangoria magazine, I do believe, I remember seeing a little painting of this, like, kind of buffed up guy, and he did kind of look like Charles Bronson. And then when we actually saw that Carpenter went to bats and got, you know, a Disney kid, not an unknown, but, you know, it was a strange choice to have Kurt Russell play the role. I get why there was some resistance, because he was very, like, feathery, very baby-faced, and the photos weren't very convincing either. He's just wearing, like, these just green pants, and it almost looks like black sneakers. He is, however, wearing the that post-punk New Wave zipper shirt. I do believe that was actually the very first part of the wardrobe, and I think, if memory serves me correctly, Kurt Russell actually bought that off a guy, just gave him money just to take it off his back in Germany somewhere. I think it might have been Berlin. He bought it from him and he thought that that would be perfect for the character of Snake Plissken, and it certainly was.
Wow, Snake Plissken, alright.
Look, I'm going to stop here. I got to shut up because this is supposed to be a mini, and I could go on and on and on talking about John Carpenter and Escape from New York, because it literally is my favorite thing in the world. But until next time, hopefully Corey and I will get the new episode out to you soon. Until then, just survive.